again. Looks like you've finally woken up. You were out for a little while longer than I anticipated, which I suppose is both good and bad news. If I had to guess, that means that she's holding on a little bit stronger than I thought, and you are not quite as magically inclined as I thought. Take both sides how you will. Either way, gave me time to get the ingredients we needed and get a few things prepped, but I figured I would wait to actually make it until you were awake. You ready to start? Okay. Well, I figured we would start with the... Let's start with the migraine dispelling potion first, that way, in case you need any more, it's ready to go for you. Okay. First thing we need is fresh water from any source purified by fire. I know I prepared that. The question is, like all things in this place, where did I put it? Had it measured out for us. Okay, doesn't say anything else besides that, just fresh water from your source, purified by fire. Here we go. Now, you don't necessarily need to be magical to combine the ingredients, but you do need someone who has magical ability to bring the properties to life at the end, as it were. Feverfew, and it says to grind it. Okay, where did I put that? It's over here. I'll just be taking this. Just get a sense for over time. Like how much to grind it. Would you like to try? It's okay. Nothing terribly wrong that could happen if you don't grind it the proper amount, but sometimes if you don't grind it up small enough, it might not be as potent as you would wish. Not really a concern in minor potions such as the migraine dispelling draft, but in more powerful potions, like if you were going for a fear induction potion, or night sight, or a smoke bomb. Those are all things that could go terribly wrong if the ingredients aren't ground up the proper way. Those are things that most mages aren't taught until their, I want to say their sixth year in schooling. Well, used to be anyway. used to be a school for mages, yes. It's been gone for a very long time, though. Maybe one day. Council is still far too fearful. I do desperately wish to see one reopened, though. No, Seers didn't go. You have a very specialized kind of magic, or potentially do. The current seer was not welcomed. Whether it be out of fear, an abundance of caution, or simply, not understanding. Shouldn't take it well. Didn't take most things well. Alright. Fever Few and Peppermint. Right in front of me. They smell lovely, don't they? They're dried from my own garden. Some things you don't have to go too far to find. Peppermint is one of those rare ingredients that you can usually eyeball. It's a middling ingredient, if that makes any sense. It's not necessarily an active component in the ways that some are, but it's almost like a binding agent. At least it serves that purpose in most spells. Would you like to smell? Sometimes I think some ingredients are added to potions simply to make them smell better. I went to school for a few years. Let's just say it didn't last too long. Find the next ingredient. Mugwort, right. Rip these up. No, you won't be drinking leaves when it's all said and done. I understand the concern, though. Part of the magical process causes all of the ingredients to bind together. Imbuing the liquid itself with their nature, both magical and non-magical. And together each thing becomes... well, more than it was on its own. How's your head doing, by the way? The potion and the sleep help? Good. I'm very glad to hear it. I'll be honest, I'm unsure if you'll be able to, imbue potions on your own. Historically speaking, some seers can, some can't. It's not that seers are mages or not mages per se, but it's something else entirely. Oh, sorry. We can talk freely about it now. I put up about 1,000 different words while you were sleeping. You can be a seer and not be a mage, just like you can be a mage and not be a seer. sake of ease, most people just refer to seers as mages, though. It makes things easier on the whole. That does tend to be how people these days refer to something they can't explain or don't understand. Must be magic. Even magic has its explanations if you know where to look. Some things are more unknown than others, but that doesn't mean it's impossible to know one day. Besides, the learning is half the fun. Or so I keep telling myself after all these years. Yes, I suppose you'll have a longer lifespan than most, you know. It's important to make your choices carefully when you've been gifted with long life. The consequences will follow you far longer. There are good things too, though, I suppose. You get to learn things that you wouldn't have otherwise. Share your knowledge. Protect things and the people you care for as long as you can. I won't lie to you. It can be quite lonely. Yes, sometimes dangerous too. The next ingredient is the valerian powder I mentioned before. Considering how well you handled the last dosage, I'm going to put less in than I was initially anticipating, but I can't really guarantee the strength of it for you. I get the feeling your abilities are going to surface quickly and suddenly, so what might be too much one day might not be enough another. That's why I'm teaching you how to make this. For as you are right now, I'm going to add half a pinch and call it there. If that doesn't work in the future, go up to a pinch, then a pinch and a half. Never exceed more than one pinch at a time. In addition, You dose it up by half, okay? Otherwise, you'll have an interesting time. It's a very fine and smooth powdery surface. And it gets on you. I wouldn't suggest inhaling that. This cape has seen its fair share, don't you worry. Then I'll be just all ready. Out of curiosity, do you smell anything different now? Sometimes, valerian powder, for those that have similar abilities, stings your nose a bit. It wouldn't have hurt you. I wouldn't have allowed that, but I'm tickled. Your predecessor. I knew her as a girl. Got to the end there, right before her powers came in full. If valerian powder got within a mile of her, she would go into a sneezing fit. I'd forgotten that. Almost there. You might want to stand back if it made your nose tickle a little bit. The powder being infused with everything will make it go up in the air, and it might be more than a tickle for you then. get this over here and I'll fill it up for us. This one is your migraine aid. I'll set that over here for now for you. Okay, now for vial of visions. It's been a long time since I've made this one. Dandelion root wine, once purified by full moon. Active components: Awand tree bark, griffin poppy, rosemary, dream cage mushroom, and crossroads dirt. Alright. Let's get that dandelion root wine. It's a fun cheery liquid. It's not particularly magical, but sometimes it's the juxtaposition between the ingredient itself and how it was transformed. Dandelion root wine is typically an energizing ingredient used in creative induction potions, productivity potions, things of the like. There's a bubbly sort of effervescence to it. Get a batch that you purified by moonlight, and you typically purify by sunlight. There's something particularly transformative for it when it's purified under the moonlight instead. Find the people I like that too. I believe griffin poppy was on the list of ingredients as well. That is... it's fairy slipper. That's rose petal. This... it's a very powerful ingredient. Quite as strong as dragon poppy. Also doesn't have the more unfortunate side effects that dragon poppy has produced. But powerful nonetheless. Quite similar to the last ingredient. That's usually used in creative and productivity potions. Doesn't smell quite as good as the mint does. I'm looking to see if I can find a whole flower. I think I found one right here. Yeah. There's a whole lot. I think the dream cage room was next, which I do have some dried and chopped into bits, but I want to get these ground up first. An importance in making sure all the pots have been opened. Because that's the real ingredient. The petals are a bit miscellaneous. Keep a lot of this on hand either. Very few potions require it. It's hard to come by. Dream cage room can only be found in specific forests, after specific rainstorms, during specific times of the year. Thankfully, most potions don't need a whole lot of it, but don't tell you those things to make you feel badly. You're worth every rare ingredient I put in here, okay? I don't know why I smelled that one. It's a mushroom. No, most potions don't require large quantities of ingredients. You'd be amazed what a little bit can do. I personally am quite thankful for. It allows me to keep my stocks full. Rosemary and crossroads dirt. Right. It's about 1 spoonful. Crushing as I go. And 1 pinch of crossroads dirt. There we go. The last piece to this puzzle. Ceylon tree bark. And that's beautiful. Name was Serana. deserve better than this. One I don't have to do anything to, actually. The bark does it for me. I'll bottle that for you now. These are for you. It's up to you. If you want to use this one. But it's here if you do. You don't need much. 3 drops under the tongue. But what I said earlier stands. Once you take it, there's no going back. So think on it first. Here. I have one more thing for you. This map is enchanted. It's been through many hands. And will hopefully go through many more before it's done. It served me and my friends well. Show you, and only you, where to find the thing you desire. And then once you've found it, it'll disappear and come back to me. This should take you to her. I give you this map and not another because where she's at is a bit, let's just say she can be found in the north. I think you know what that means. This will show you the way, the safest way. And then she's more than capable of helping you find your way back. If you choose to see her. No rush, though. The map stays with you until you're ready. I wish I had more answers for you, I really do. I wish I had more answers for a lot of things these days. I have the sneaking suspicion I'll find them soon enough. Well. Safe travels, my friend. I have a feeling I'll be seeing you again. Fair winds, and farewell.